Hello. May I speak to Randy Schekman, please?
Speaking.
Oh, hello. This is Adam Smith from Nobel Media in Stockholm.
Yes.
We have this tradition of recording very short interviews with new laureates. Would you be willing to talk for a few minutes?
Of course.
Thank you very much indeed. Well, first of all, congratulations on the award, of
course.
Thank
you. Thank you.
What were you doing when the call came?
Well, I was sleeping. It was a quarter after 1 in the morning here, and I'd just come back from Frankfurt yesterday, where I spent a week at a meeting, and so I was quite exhausted. But of course, I was aware of what happens in the morning. So as soon as the phone started ringing, my wife yelled out, "There it is! There it is!" And I sort of sized up things and picked up the phone, and there was Göran Hansen. So it was a real thrill to hear from him.
Lovely. And what was your first action after the call?
After the call, well, I danced around with my wife and repeatedly said, "Oh my God, oh my God," and then I called my father, my 86-year-old father, who has been hoping for this for many years, and he was shaken but thrilled. And I called my two children, Joel and Lauren, and got them out of bed, and they were excited.
That's lovely. So now there's celebrations all over the country.
Yeah. Yeah.
People always joke that the award of a Nobel Prize gets you a parking space at Berkeley. Do you think that?
Yeah. Right. Right. That's. In fact, when I was the chairman of the biochemistry division, I negotiated with two young faculty who were moving from MIT, and who were very concerned about their opportunity to have parking permits for themselves as assistant professors. And in the formal letter of offer, I assured them that they not only could pay for parking, but if they happened to win a Nobel Prize, they'd get their parking for free. And they claimed that that was really the part of the contract that really sealed the deal for them.
it's an unusual incentive to work hard.
it is unusual, yeah.
You are credited with doing the initial work that took our understanding of vesicle traffic from a purely descriptive to the beginnings of a mechanistic understanding. And that understanding has taken a lot of time to achieve.
Yeah, yeah. So, yes, so, well, I want to credit George Pallade, who really pioneered the field of cell biology by developing the techniques of electron microscopy to visualize membranes within human cells, and it was his genius to realize to appreciate how proteins that are going to be exported from cells are assembled in a kind of an assembly line process inside the cell. And when I began my laboratory in 1976, and really around the same time when Jim Rossen began his laboratory at Stanford, we conceived of two very different approaches to try to identify the machinery responsible for this mechanism. And I used a technique of classical yeast genetics to make mutations in yeast cells that define the pathway. And Rothman used a very complementary biochemical process to reconstitute the pathway in vitro. And over a period of years, as we compared notes, sometimes collaboratively, sometimes competitively, it became clear that he and I were working on many of the same proteins, many of the same genes and proteins. And so that synthesis between the two sets really convinced us that we were on the right track to the project on, as I did.
Last question. How do you feel about the onslaught of press attention that's about to arrive?
The onslaught of?
Of attention that's about to
attention.
Arrive. That will follow this
yeah,
the announcement.
Yeah, well, I don't know what to expect. Of course, around this time of year, I'm always reminded this could happen. And in fact, I just returned from Germany where I got another award, the Otto Warburg Prize, and the whole time people were saying, well, we'll see what happens on Monday. So I guess I was sort of primed for this today, although I came back from Europe yesterday, so I'm pretty pretty jet lagged.
Yes, but I imagine you'll be living on the high of it for some time.
Yeah, oh yeah, I'll stay awake today.
Okay. Well, I wish you a really splendid day, and once again, congratulations. Thank you for talking to us, and I look forward to talking again soon.
Thank you.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.